Trimming is the process to finish the bottom of your piece. There are many different styles to trimming. Your goal is to physically and visually remove the excess weight at the bottom and shape the bottom so that it sits nicely on the floor or the tabletop. For functional pieces such as bowls, cups, and plates, you also want to think about how the piece will sit inside of your hand and how it will feel when you hold the piece in your hand. Take a look at previous videos on how to center for trimming. And once your piece is centered, then the first step is to anchor your piece down. I am making coils with wads of clay, and these are going to be my anchors. My piece is drier than when I threw it, so my clay is not as sticky and will not stick to the wheel unless I anchor it down with clay wads. The clay wads should be the consistency of right out of the bag of clay that you have. Not too sticky, and if it's too dry, then your wads of clay will fly off along with your piece and you can lose your piece. So make sure that your wads of clay are sticky, tacky enough to hold down the piece. Now notice how I am putting on the wads of clay. I'm making long strips that go out and not make a circle around the piece with tiny wads of clay. This is especially important for tall pieces, since tall and narrow pieces tend to be more unstable. And think about these wads of clay as your base, that you need a wider base to stabilize your tall piece. Now I have a small trimming tool and a larger trimming tool. You have one of the larger ones. If you want, I suggest to get the small one. The small one gives me a little more control on fine details, but the big one does not matter. It is as sufficient as the small one. I'm holding it like a pencil with my right hand. If you're left-handed, you have to mirror what I'm doing. And I am supporting my right hand with my left hand. See, my left hand is touching my right hand, and my left hand is calmly touching the piece on the left side at the top of the piece. Now the top of the piece wobbles less, and I'm not holding on to the piece. I just have my left hand resting on the piece as support. Don't think about grabbing it or this piece can go flying off. Now see how I'm trimming from the top to the bottom. This has less resistance than you bringing the tool up from the bottom. You might notice that I created lines by trimming. So you can use the flat side of your trimming tool to smooth the lines. And in this case, I am going from the bottom to the top because I am no longer chewing up the clay to remove the excess weight. I am just smoothing and cleaning up the surface of the piece. Once the sides are done, then we will finish the bottom of the piece. First, we need to determine where we want to put the foot or the ring on the bottom. So I've made a little line. I made a line with the needle tool just to give me an idea of where the foot should be. And I am trimming away the excess clay to that line that I made. So that is going to be the outer edge of the ring. Notice how I'm using the tool at a 45 degree angle to cut off the excess clay going from the top to the bottom. Now, to pronounce the edge on the ring, I'm using my tool at a different angle. It's about 90 degree angle. And to soften the edge of the ring, I'm using it again at a 45 degree angle. These angles can change depending on how you like it, but play around with the tool. Some people like to do different angles. This is how I trim, and it's good for me. Now, once you have the outer edge of the ring,